Hey, good morning, guys. Listen, I had something on my heart this morning, and I wanted to share it. Felt like it was something that needed to be said, and just felt like it was something that maybe someone needed to hear. And so I woke up this morning, and I had an opportunity to look through Facebook for a moment, and you know, I saw a post where someone was expressing RIP, right? Rest in peace. Some of us use the terminology rest in paradise, but regardless, right, of what acronym you use and, you know, how creative we get with those three letters, ultimately, we're looking to express rest, right? Rest in peace, rest in paradise. And I started to think to myself, why is it that we wait until we die, until we pass away, right, to access something that is always and has always been available? Why do we wait until we die to access something that's always available? I was thinking whether it's us saying RIP for an individual who's passed away, or unconsciously, right, thinking to ourselves and believing in our own hearts that even our peace, our rest, is something that has to wait. It's something that's waiting for us in the future, in the other side of glory, as we say, when we pass away. Rest in God's presence, rest in peace, rest in paradise. But it's always kind of used in the context of someone dying, someone passing away. And I was really thinking to myself, why is it that we're waiting to access rest and peace, even paradise, for when we die? Why are we waiting to access something that's available now? The Bible says that Jesus says, if you are, you know, burdened, weighed down, you have a heavy heart, stressed out, worried, frustrated, he says, come to me if you're that person, and I will give you my rest. He says that my yoke, right, it's easy. My burdens, they're light. Jesus has this open invitation, open arms, welcoming us into his presence, into his care, right now in the land of the living. We don't have to wait until we die to RIP. And so I was just thinking of this idea, man. We need to begin to RIP one another now, right? Not too long ago, you know, it's become popular to give people their roses, right, or their flowers while they're still living. And I love that sentiment, right? I love that idea. We're not gonna wait till you pass away. We're not gonna wait until you're in the casket for us to give you your flowers, right? We're gonna celebrate you. We're gonna honor you. We're gonna, you know, show some love and some appreciation. We're gonna celebrate your life while you're still living, while you can still enjoy it. And in the same way, I'm just thinking that Jesus is saying to us, even in this season of crisis and chaos and, you know, calamity and challenges, come to me and I'll give you your roses, your flowers while you're still living. I'll give you the rest that your soul desires, that your soul is thirsty for, that your soul is desiring right now. So I just think that it's a great idea for us to begin to send some RIPs in the land of the living. Tell a friend, a family member, a loved one, a coworker, RIP right now. We're not gonna wait until you die. We're not gonna wait until you're in a casket. We're not gonna wait until you're 6 feet under. We're gonna begin to RIP you now, giving people permission to rest now. Rest in your peace in the present tense, right? Not when you die, but in the land of the living, you can access this rest, this peace. It's available now to access. Jesus has an open door policy, an open arm policy. It is waiting. It is available. It is there now. It's accessible now. It's available now, guys. So no more only RIP. I'm not sending out an anti-RIP message. I'm not telling you to, you know, to not use RIP when someone passes away. I'm not telling you to not post it on Facebook and Instagram. I'm not telling you to not put it on a billboard. I'm not telling you to not write it on a piece of cardboard, right? And to express it when someone passes away. I get it, right? I've experienced the passing of my mother. I get desiring to express this idea of rest now. The challenges are over now. The weight of the world is now finally off your shoulders, right? I get the idea of saying to someone, rest in peace now, because you're so happy in one sense. You're sad in one sense, but you're happy in another sense that the pain is over, the struggle is over, the toiling of their lives, it's finally over, and now they can rest. I'm just saying that in addition to that, we can also RIP one another. Right now, we can RIP one another in the land of the living in the present tense. Rest now in your peace. Rest now in your paradise. Rest. Just rest now. Jesus is calling you. Jesus is saying you can rest. Yes, you can rest right now. You don't have to wait until you pass away. And if you're desiring to bless a person or to pronounce blessings upon a person or to decree and to declare on the life of another one, right? If you're into that type of thing, right? If you're into speaking good things, right? Sending good vibes. If you're into celebrating other people, encouraging other people, edifying, you know, other people. If you're into that type of thing, right? RIP somebody today. Tell them it doesn't have to just mean once you pass away. Rest is available right now. You can begin to rest in peace today. Just thought I would share this idea, this concept. It was dropped on my heart this morning as I looked at that post. And again, I get it. I am not saying don't use it when someone passes away. I'm just introducing an idea that we can begin to use it even now. I pray that this makes sense. I pray that it reaches those who would need to hear it. And I pray that it would be a blessing.